Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to create a Google site for your project. So go ahead and log into your Google account and go to the sites page and then select a blank document. Feel free to explore the pre-made templates as well. I just find it easier to use the blank template. So your template is going to start with a cover page with a title area. Go ahead and title it whatever you like. If you don't like how the formatting comes out, you can change the size of the text by selecting all and using these editing tools at the top. We can just reduce the size of the text. You can also use the little circles on the side of the text box to stretch or change the shape of it. If you want to add an image for the background, you can select Change Image, and I'm going to actually select an image. You can search by name if you want. And select any image you find interesting. I like this one here. And it's going to insert it into the background. And it will change the tone of it a little bit to make it more readable. From here, you can select from different layouts, or you can select individual boxes here. I'm going to go ahead and put a text box in just to introduce my project. So you can see the text box appears. I'm going to give it a header, kind of like a title, and then I'm going to type some text. So go ahead and let's take that part out and let's make the welcome our text. So go ahead and call that the heading. It's going to change the format a little bit and make it a little bit more clear where the divisions are between each text box. Okay, so at this point, I can go ahead and create a separate unit for each block of the project. So these are the three different submissions. On the right-hand side, go to Pages, and then create a unique page for each part of it. So I'm just going to call that Part 1, Part 2, and Part 3. You'll notice as you create these individual pages that it copies the background image. You can change that for each individual part if you want. Oops, I need one more part. Okay. Oh, I don't like the way that came out, so I can change that. So I need one more part. Part 3. There we go. Okay, so now we're going to add a subpage for each chapter that's included in each of the three parts. Hover your mouse cursor over the title and you'll see these three dots appear. Click that and scroll down until you can select Add a Subpage. So you can name it Chapter 1, Chapter 2, and so on, or you can name it by chapter title, or you can name it whatever you like that makes sense. I'm going to call this one The Story of Invention. Okay, so you can see it appears sort of as a nested folder system. I'm going to create another subpage for the next chapter. That's good. Okay, so let's go ahead and add another one. And there's one more in this block. You'll notice that as you create these subpages, it is duplicating again that background picture and all of the different formatting that you had for the original homepage. You can change that later to make it more aligned with the topics that you're talking about. So let's go to that first subpage and start creating. go back to the insert area here on the right hand side, and feel free to select any of these layouts if you want. That's a nice way to get started in your design. You can also design by hand by using the text box or image insert options. So let's go ahead. I'm going to start with a picture and some text. Okay, so under the story of invention, okay, let's change this to a header instead, since we already have a title at the top. Okay, good. And we can add some text. Okay, so that's a nice thing to say, the invention of photography. So this just introduces my page. I'm going to go ahead and add an image just to make it interesting. You can select an image again in the same way you did before. Okay. Let's look for a picture of Daguerre himself. Great. So let's insert a picture of Daguerre. Maybe his signature. That's nice. Okay, good. Let's go ahead and add another text and image box for the next thing we want to talk about. And I'm going to add another daguerreotype. You can notice that it's not quite the right size, so you can click on the image and click this little icon here to uncrop it to make it full size. Create a title and then create some text to describe it. I'm not going to put in too much text here because that's what you're going to do when you finish your project. Now, when you put in a picture like this, I want you to include a citation so that the person looking at your webpage can know what the picture is. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. If it's a picture from the textbook, you can just copy that information there. You can insert a new text box to do that. You can also double click in the area you want to add it and you'll get these options appear. So I'm going to click a text box and go ahead and put in that information. This is directly from the textbook, so I'm not worried too much about making any mistakes, except for, there we go, that's correct. And now the image has its title there, and I can add more information as I see fit. The more information and the more detail that you add, the more you're going to demonstrate how much that you know about that topic. Continue to look at the end of each weekly lesson for ideas about things that you should include in your compendium site. And then at the end of each block in the semester, you're going to submit the link to your project and I'll look at it and have an opportunity to see how much you've learned. Okay, so once you finish your project, be sure to publish it so that it can be viewed by others. Go up to the top right-hand side and press the publish button. You can give it a unique web address if you want to. I'm just going to call it My Compendium and then maybe the date. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, so that looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and publish it. When I want to turn it in or share it with a classmate, I can go up to the link icon here and get the address, copy the link, and then you can share it with anyone you want. You can also preview what it looks like on different devices by clicking this icon right here for preview. Okay, so this is what the page will look like on a computer. You can also preview what it looks like on a phone. And you can see here's how the menus will appear. And since we created all of these subpages, we can click that and see the subpages for each chapter that we created. You'll continue to do this for each chapter throughout the semester. And that's it. I look forward to seeing your projects.